Hey, what's going on, my friends? Welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Victor, and today I'm going to share with you five things I think you should know about this upcoming full moon on September 24th, 2018. I wrote down as an underlying theme, you getting exactly what you need to become the person you came to be. I know a lot of people who watch me understand the idea of a light worker. A lot of you know you've come here for a purpose. Even if you haven't found it, even if you're frustrated by the whole notion of a purpose, you feel your life means something. You have an innate desire to do, to help, to express. And for a long time, a tiresome length of time, it wasn't the time to do that. We all kind of knew, I think, it was time to be patient, time to allow for the perfect timing to present itself. Even though we wanted to, that built-in urge never ceased. I'm telling you, the wait is over. It's time to turn on the lights within yourself, within the collective. The timing is ripe and ready for the you came to express and share and gift to the world. And you will attract whatever it is you need, which can range from a lot of different types of stuff, to really step into the fullness of yourself. Maybe you're attracting a lot of different circumstances that are reflecting lessons you need to let go of. Maybe you're attracting the kind of support you need to fully be yourself. There, it could be a lot of different things, but you're going to be like a magnet for any and all things you need to be who you came to be now. The time is now. Number one, figuring out your blocks, which will present themselves as less blocky, less solid, less real, more of just a pattern of your mind that you'll start to see through. A good example comes from a movie I just watched yesterday called The King's Speech. The movie's about a king who stutters, and he has his voice coach to help him give speeches for obvious reasons, but it's very difficult for him. And there's a situation where the two characters first meet for the first time, and this voice coach is like, listen, I will bet you one coin that you can read this paper right here perfectly. The king took one look at it and said no. He got angry because he's never done it before. He's been stuttering as long as he can remember. He thinks it's some kind of mechanical voice type of malfunction, that it's like a physical thing. And he says, all right. They shook on it. And the voice coach put these headphones on the king that played very, very loud music. And sure enough, the king spoke beautifully, which goes to show there's not really a mechanical stuttering block or problem. It's just a pattern that the king became identified with throughout his life. And that's the same situation with all of our blocks, all the things that prevent us from being who we really want to be and doing the things we really want to do and going for the things we want to go for are not ultimately all that blocky. They're not all that real. It's us tugging on our own sleeve as we try to go forward. And this full moon is going to help you wake up to that. And that's all it takes, a simple seeing it for what it is. Once the king saw, that was a game changer. That really was the stepping stone he needed to finally step into his fullness, which he did by the end of the film. That's going to happen to you during this full moon. There might be a lot of different types of blocks, not just one. A lot of blocks. We have a lot of blocks. And a lot of them might come up for you at once. And initially, they can kind of take you over. They can seem confusing and overwhelming. But as you continue to expand, there will be a growing space between your consciousness and your blocks. And just as if you were to take a rocket ship off of planet Earth, you would see the planet gets smaller and smaller and smaller and smaller the further away you get. Number two, I wrote down seeing clearly what's important. The more awake you become, the more you embody truly the perspective of your old, ancient, eternal soul. And what the core values, we'll say, of your soul are different than a lot of the core values that we find ourselves acting upon or from on planet Earth, just as we go through life. What I mean, and you can sort of look this up if you want. Anyone who's really crossed over and come back, if you ever read about near-death experiences, almost all of them who had a clear, vivid experience will come back and say that they've changed permanently. And what's different are their values, their priorities. And it really all comes down to how do they love, how did they treat others, how much did they learn, how much value did they add to the people in their life. And I think right now we can hear this and say, yeah, I agree, that's what matters most, right? We all believe that. And yet, we don't always act from that. We allow our doubts and our insecurities and our pain to cause us to spend an unnecessary amount of time, energy, and focus on things that ultimately do not matter, that have nothing to do with those core values that are starting to return within you. Your soul's values and priorities will start to take more precedence in your everyday actions and decisions, and you'll notice this, and this will bring you a great deal of peace and serenity. It'll take the edge off of life because we're finally residing in what matters, and all that going on, all the fluctuations with our finances and our friends and all the different things going on will be more on the peripheral where they belong. Number three, I wrote down honing in on your niche. What is that? What's a niche? It's not important. Niche is like a specific area of expertise or study. I use that as a metaphor for you narrowing down who it is you came to be. A lot of people I would work with, they knew they were a healer. They knew they came to heal. They just felt sensitive to the energy, and they had an innate knowing that, or an innate attraction to Reiki or the dozens or even hundreds of different healing arts, and there was a resonance there. They'd show up to a class and they would be a natural. They'd be awesome at it, but they would still find themselves like, Victor, I don't know what to do with this. I'm good at healing. It's like something very easy for me. I feel like an expert already, but I don't even have the credentials. I don't even know how. This full moon is going to help sort of squeeze you into your specific little area of healing as an example. What exactly did you come to do? You'll start off with this big opening and you'll slowly walk forward, and it will sort of refine, you'll get more of a refined clarity of what it is you came to do. And the clearer, the finer the path, the finer you narrow yourself down, the more fulfilling it will be. Because it's almost like you can look at like this big open end as all like diluted aspects of you. And the closer you get to that little pinpoint, if you go forward, that's where like all of you is concentrated in that little pinpoint, and you're walking towards that. And as you go forward and narrow down your niche and find and reclaim and embody more of your true authentic self, the better, the more vitalized, the more alive, the more content, the more at peace you will feel, because you'll be finally home in who you are and always have been. And now this beautiful full moon, this lifetime, is allowing you to rediscover yourself in a very bold and immaculate way. Number four, as you become more fully yourself, you'll find that the universe, because it's giving you everything you need to kind of usher you forward, because the world is ready for you, you'll find that as you start to shine, clarify who it is you are, and express that to the world, even in a very passive way, just walking around, walking through life, walking to the store, being yourself, you might find that there are people in your life that become triggered by that. So I wrote down for number four is going forward quickly, but don't look back. Because there will be what I call, and it's not something I made up, it's something I heard down the line, there'll be crabs in your life. I'll explain. So if you ever heard the little story of the nice old man walking down the beach, he stumbles upon a crab fisherman, an expert crab fisherman. And he would watch this crab fisherman in awe as this guy would walk up into the water. He'd drop his net. He would confidently walk away. And then he'd get up 5 minutes later after chewing on some sunflower seeds and pull that net in, and there'd be 10, 15, 20 crabs. He'd throw them in a bucket. And this guy was like, wow, this dude is good. I'm going to go talk to him. So this old man walks up to the crab fisherman. They're talking, kind of having a good time. And the old man notices that one of the crabs is about to escape the bucket. And he interrupts the fisherman and says, hey, dude, listen, there's a crab about to escape, man. They're going to get out. And the fisherman kind of chuckles and no, I don't have to worry about that. Just watch. Sure enough, just as that crab was about to liberate itself and taste freedom for the first time and get up and escape, all his little crab buddies dragged him back down. That's an unfortunate reality of when one accelerates their growth, that usually at some point they will have to deal with crabs in their life, which is why it's important to go forward and not look back. In my experience, it doesn't serve to resent the crabs. I don't believe they're consciously trying to drag me or drag you down. At the same time, they are a formidable force, and a whole bucket of crabs versus one guy, one little crab buddy, it's not, it can, they can succeed. They can hold you down if you allow them. So go forward. Don't feel bad shining. Don't feel guilty being who you actually are. Go forward and get cut the crabs out of your life. Number five, I just wrote down two words. Exponential expansion. As you attract that which you need to heal yourself quickly and stop getting in your own way, you'll realize the vast potential of your soul to expand its expression of itself and therefore reflect in your reality that expansion and how exponential and like geometric it can be. I'm trying to think of a good analogy, but what comes to mind is something that wants to shoot up into the air, but just being held down really tight. This thing wants to fly. It doesn't have to learn to fly. I wish I had an object in mind. I can't think of it. Some kind of balloon or something. It's being smothered down right now. It has this force going up, but it's holding itself back. You're holding yourself back. The world is holding you back. But once that stops happening, it's not a matter of learning to ascend. You just ascend. The balloon just goes up once you let go of it. And it's fast. You might have been like making inches upward for most of your life until you finally let go of that balloon and you just shoot up there and you're watching it up at the sky. Before you know it, you can't even see it. It's so high, it just gets smaller and smaller and smaller and higher and higher and higher. And that's literally the type of experience you will have in this lifetime of this transformation going on, because you're transforming to such a degree. You're letting go of so much that it's just a matter of time before you let go of that balloon. And when you do, it's fast, man. It happens quickly. You might find yourself mesmerized, dumbfounded at the opportunities that start to just fall into your life. Things you could have never seen or even wished for just pop in when you heal yourself from the inside, which is what all of you are doing right now. And this full moon is like such a helpful force. And if you can allow yourself to curiously inquire to the different things coming into your life that are necessary for you to make this exponential leap, and you could make the healings happen by simply allowing your life to unfold, then you will start to attract these types of exponential expansive experiences. I'm referring to the time is ripe, the time is ready for you to shine, and you finally have the support. It's time for you. The universe won't hold you back. You'll learn to stop holding yourself back. And once that happens, get ready. It's go time. Thank you, my friends, for listening and watching. I have a podcast now, so I sometimes get confused and say, I call them viewers, I call you listeners, I'm all over the place. Thank you, my friends. Thank you for the work you're doing. It's not easy. I know people watching this video are going through a rapid personal transformation right now, and I am too. It's why sometimes I don't come on for 4 or 5 or 6 days for YouTube, because I'm going through my own shifts as well. And sometimes I feel all blocked up, but I'm happy to be here. I'm happy to be in this with you guys, doing this together. It's a blessing. It's a beautiful time to be alive. And I thank you for your work. You guys have an amazing day. And real quick, if you're new to my channel, what up? Welcome. I don't know if you've heard from my other videos, but I do have a free guided meditation that I made myself. It was just like these videos. It was inspired from within, and it's for the purpose of helping you learn how to heal yourself during these shifts you're going through. It's totally free. There's a link down below at the top of the description box. Take it if you'd like. With that said, I'm gonna close this video out. I'm in San Diego right now. Just got done having a good weekend, and I'm looking forward to getting back and getting back on the ball. Anyways, you guys have an amazing day. Thank you so much. Namaste.